Hello everyone, I'm Dragonwhelp and welcome back to FortressCraft Evolved. When we last left off, we were doing a bunch of innovations of getting the recombined organic material. Today, I thought we'd take a chance, sit back, relax, and do a little bit of base improvement. So far, we're just a big solar panel on a bunch of snow digging into the side of a mountain. And I decided to put a lot of this new stuff that we've gotten, but really haven't taken a look at. One of these said things is the construction paste grinder, which I set up right here. You set up hoppers around it with just random old materials in them, and it turns it into construction paste. You can then turn around and use this construction paste to make a wide variety of colors, which just three at the moment. You got red, blue, and green canvas, which are represented here. You have red, you have the green, you have the blue, and you have the white. White's a special case, which you can make from going into your C menu when you're not hovering over a crafter, and there you go, you have white canvas right there. So what I'm thinking about doing is turning this place into some type of castle. As you can see, I started fiddling around with ideas, how I figured out how I wanted to do certain things. So what I'm going to do is essentially just make it kind of like a fort of sorts. I'm going to build this up kind of like this, make it look like it is actual castle, kind of, with the CPH being the main center or the main brain of it. This is just the inner wall. This is not going to be like the final, outside. I eventually will make tiers of batteries, of walls going around to encompass the entirety of the base. Because if I built this wall or built the castle, up as it is, it would not encompass any of the machinery that we have going on right here. So I think I'm going to stick with the color scheme that I have, which I was using rock, because it looks really similar to actual how stone is. There's no other stone in the game that I think looks that way. I mean, I could use the canvas here, but that looks like it would be more or less for flooring. So I figured I would get right to work, and I thought it would be a cool little idea if I could move the turrets, kind of like how I have up here. I could move the turrets around. Well, these are going to stay here, but the turrets are going to be like the center point of the actual towers on each of the cardinal direction away from the CPH, because the bugs come from that direction, they'll come from that direction, in that direction, and that direction respectively. So I'm going to make it to where it's all uniform, and I'm going to line it all up. This is the time to do it. I've done a few calculations, and I think I have the symmetry up. So I'm going to use this battery here as a basis for everything. So here we go. I'm going to grab the batteries out for these the storage blocks that we're going to need, because we're going to have to move this over to here. Yes, right there. And then we're going to come out like this. There we go. And then we'll have to grab the Mach 3 storages. And then we're going to have to take this one. Actually, let's just take all the guns off of it, so that way we could take it down with no problem. So it would be 1, 2, 3, 4 with that there. And then this would get cut. And then we would do, I need to go grab all those. Run kind of low. There's only so much I can do. There we go. Let's see if I can jump. I got it. There we go. Now the only problem with this is I'll have to change where this battery is located, which is not a big deal. I can just move it out two blocks, and I can actually go ahead and upgrade it to the Mach 3 laser, because we actually have abundance of Mach 3 lasers going on. Now I'm trying to figure out where this is adjacent to, and this can get cut. And I may just throw an extra battery there. That looks good. Then I'll cover this. Let's grab my hewn blocks out. There we go. So now that we've gotten that set up going, we can actually put the guns back. Let's see, grab the guns. And they go on the outside. There we go. We're still waiting on the recombined organic matter down in the caves. I periodically go down there to make sure it's full of organic matter. But right now we're just waiting for it to start working and get finished up. So from here, I'm actually going to make like a little stair step so that way I can get back up and down if I need to. But I think little walkways like this with the red canvas look kind of decent. I don't know. Tell me what you guys think. Should I change it to one of these other colors down there? Or is red good enough? Or should I just use a different type of stone altogether? If I need to, I can use pretty much anything. It's not like I don't have any of the resources available to me. I could go get it, which is not a big deal. I mean, I could even make this thing entirely out of dirt. I just want some feedback from you guys to see, you know, make it feel like it's ours, not just me building it and creating it and doing things. Make it like we all have part in making it. So this is going to be where I'm thinking it's going to be tricky, is I'm wanting to make some type of diverse power system, because right now the power from this is coming from the CPH. But what I could do is probably do like a basis around here with keeping maybe one block open. And give me that. So I want to build up here. There we go. Let's just build this all up. There we go. And bridge this gap. It should be good. And then just work all of our batteries up here. So I should be like this, and I'm out. But then I have the three in the, or the four in the middle. Yeah, that should work. So what I can do from here is I will turn this off, grab all the guns. And then what I'll do is I'll actually set it up to where this will be completely drained into that one up there. And then I'll just leave maybe like one battery, probably this battery here, where that laser could cut into it. So that way it can still get power and it's fed through the entirety of the system. I probably could hide this in some manner, like this, have like a little line where the batteries, the power line goes, and just work around it somehow. I don't know. I thought it would be a good idea to make the towers. It's just I never really thought, you know, exactly how to do all the power lines and do everything else. As you can see off in the distance, I have a Mach 4 storage battery. I could probably use that for probably make another couple Mach storages to make sure all these stay, you know, nice and powered. But yeah, I think we'll be all right. And then once these batteries get a good and drained, I should be able to pick them up and transfer a lot of them upstairs. Speaking of, I can come up here and put the guns up here because we're being attacked. It's not good to be defenseless. So I may need, let's see, how many do I need? Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So grab these. Go ahead and fill this in. There we go. And then what I can do is, what was I doing here? Oh, I was making more crystal clocks. So I could take this up because this is no longer going to be here. I'll need to change this up to be something else. These batteries are going to die pretty shortly. But what we could do is just go ahead and build this up. And man, I tell you, when building big structures like this, the super tool is very, very good to have. So now that we've got these batteries up here and running, we can put the guns on. And I'm actually going to do the little castle type thing. Do it like every other block. Oh, thanks for the report. There we go. Make it look like a proper castle with the little, you know, arrow loops and stuff in it. Do it over here as well. Got one there. Oh, we'll need one there. Actually, it would be right there and then there. Yeah. See? That looks cool already. It looks a lot better. And then we'll want to build this up to where it looks nice and neat. And just go around doing the exact same thing on all four sides. And then only one we have left to move is that side over there, which shouldn't be hard to do. Now, granted, I'm hoping that I don't have to change anything on the bottom floor, which it doesn't look like I'm going to, so that's nice. But I may have to find some way of moving things around, reincorporating it some other way, to make it look more aesthetically pleasing, I guess one would say. Because you come down here to the ore refinery, that might actually work, because it's not like too far in and not too far out, and then it works well with the wall structure. Yeah, I think that'll work. And then eventually we probably could, you know, line the entirety of the top of this up. You know what, the first order of business is to make a staircase that goes up there. Because this is going to be painful jumping all the way up and down. So I need to be there, and then there. And we don't need this anymore. We know where the hive mines are located. Just in case we need to go back and actually look for some more hive mines, well, we can have them just, I guess I could just have them laying around somewhere. Where would be a good place to put these, actually? I actually got rid of my rock. I shouldn't have done that. There we go. All right. Oh, I need to Well, that didn't work out the way I wanted it, so I have to add one to every single one of these. It's not a big deal. There we go. Now I got a staircase going up to the top. I may move that staircase later. I guess it just depends on what kind of feedback I get, what comments I get in the comments below, or just, you know, whatever I feel like if I haven't got anything of the sort. So, yeah, I'm thinking this looking pretty good. Just go around, put in the blocks. I mean, like I said, it may not be the good block selection, but I thought the rock actually looked castle-like, because that's the closest thing to castle structure. Now, if there was a block that looked more like cobblestone, you know, I would sign on to that really, you know, super, super fast. I mean, the closest thing we have would be something like a metal truss, which I may use in parts or for buildings and stuff. Like for this little area here, I might, you know, truss it off, make it look like it's an actual workshop. Yeah. See, that looks nice because you can actually see through it, see what's going on. But it's not so, you know, it's not like it's going to be in the way. Like I can make a doorway here. Do something like put that there and put a truss all the way across. You see, and this would be like our little doorway or entryway into the workshop where the power goes and whatever. Yeah, I kind of like that. I quite like that a lot. And then we could just have like blocks coming down from the ceiling, covering it in. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. You got to be careful though when you're building with the construction paste materials. If you accidentally overwrite it or change it or delete it, you get paste back instead, which I don't know if that was the intended thing for it or what, but something that's cost like 15 or 16 construction paste winds up getting, man, I messed up, blah, blah, blah. And then you break it, you know, it comes back and it gives you one construction paste. Granted, construction paste is easy to come by, but, you know, I'm not sure if that was the intended thing for it. But needless to say. Looking good here, man. Looking really, really good. I kind of like that. That gives us like a little entryway into our workshop area. So let's continue keeping power to these guys. May need to change that where this power comes from. But then again, this is all going to be, you know, only thing I will actually see would be this little hole. So, but that's another thing I need to think about. I need to break this a little bit or something. Yeah, never mind. I'll leave that there for now. But this could be like my little entryway and exit. You enter the castle from this side. So I could build like a little wall area here. Let's see. Is that right? Yeah. And then we'll have something like that. Does that work? Yeah, and I can have like a little entryway here. It doesn't have to be too big or too fancy. It just has to be functional, I guess you could say. And then I'll just put the lights here. And I'll put another light, let's say right there. Make sure this place is all nice and lit up. I need to get my rocks back out, because we're moving away from the rocks. There we go. Yeah, I like that a lot. I like that a lot. But this could be like the side entrance. It's not a main entrance at all. The main entrance, I have no idea. I probably don't need to need a main entrance because, you know, I could just grapple to the top here like a little ninja getting jumping in and out of its house. But yeah, so far so good. I'm liking it a lot. Build this up here. Get a little wall going on. Because this is not only going to serve two purposes. One, it decorates the base enough to where it's not just plain Jane, and it doesn't, you know, it's not very appealing to the eye. This may not even be appealing to the eye, but at least it's something creative and something, you know, thoughtful. Whereas before, it was just, you know, snow on the ground. But the second thing that it actually does is it allows us to keep the bugs out for an extended period of time, because the bugs have to actually go through the blocks. They either have to either go under it or go over it, which, since there's actually blocks underneath, they'll have to go over to get to the CPH. So it actually is a protective barrier to keep our CPH nice and protected, especially when we start getting the boss creatures coming after us. I have decided that the spider bot platform, I'm going to clear off the top of that mountain there where all that is up there. I'm not going to do it right now, but I'll eventually do it. The spider bot is going to be living, that his little base is going to be up there. Because right now it's just massively in the way. It's just there. It's going to be in a way of construction of what I plan on doing, especially with this you know, walling area, walled off area here. You know what? I actually should have moved that out to here. Yeah, I need to fix that. I need to fix that, like, now. So let's get the measurements. Okay, this should be good. This should be high enough at least. It may not be. Give me this. There we go. Where's that coming at? All right. So I need to build one higher. That's not too bad. There we go. So I'll need to move this platform out. To here. So the big battery, the main battery starts there. So it'll be here. And then the four big batteries would be there. Okay. No problem. I can get this fixed really quick. Be right back. There we go. I fixed it. Not a problem. And then we could just replace our turrets there. Like nothing happened. This battery is going to be here for reasons that I can't move that one down there any further. But I don't think that would cause too much of an issue. because 90% of this is going to be hidden. And if I could find an easier way to move stuff around and make the batteries easier to be placed or recharged by other batteries, then I'll move it. But until then, I'll just leave it like it is because it looks nice. And then I thought of another cool thing. Since we have the entrance way over here to our workshop, we can also do something similar to this over here for our ore processing. So we can have like a truss doorway of sorts. Kind of like, didn't mean to do that. So that's three, that's fine. There we go. And then I'll have two little lights right here. Yeah, see, now I'm in the workshop or in the ore processing area. And it all connects eventually in the backside, but I quite like it. I quite like it a lot. And then we could just move this one, move this battery up. And have something similar to that over there where the battery is hidden underneath, which is awesome. Which is awesome. It's coming together quite nicely, I think. And we can sit there and we do this. There we go. And we can start this off by placing the first battery right here. Since we're not being attacked from this direction, it's best to go ahead and do this side first. So that way, we don't really need the protection at the moment. So it's best to get it over and done with. Let's get it, get that power shot up there. I should be able to turn this back on now. Oh, I forgot I needed to move it. There we go. It's pretty much all you need right there. Keep it well nice and charged. Too bad there's no such thing as doors in this game. Otherwise, I'd put a door right there. I'd actually have to move this so I can cover this up. But I am going to leave this little entryway into here. That way I can get in here and do maintenance on this, upgrade this to a different big battery, or upgrade the laser beam or whatever have you. So I'll leave that there. Probably want to put like a light or something in there, but I think it'll be all right. Like I said, this place is not the prettiest in the world, but you know, it looks kind of cool. I quite like it. I quite like it a lot. May have to change all that over there from hewn rock to actual rock, but it'll be all right. So let's build up this side over here. And since we have a few extra batteries from the other project over there, and actually find our little middle point for these. There we go. Everything's being charged. Everything's all nice and neat. Everything's all lined up. I think, am I lining this up correctly? Yes. Okay, wait. No, I'm not. Oh, I have to fix it again. After I break my legs for the 50th time. Oh man, why did I not do that? Ugh. It's unfortunate. It'd be all right. It's gonna bug me if I don't. So it needs to be leaving with this. So I just need to move them over one. So it needs to start here. Okay. So I'll pick this one up. Put this over there. I gotta go down and get them. It's all right. I know I'm being wasteful here, but it's okay. I need all these to fix that up there. All right, is that all of them? Yeah, looks like it. Okay, so that would be proper. So let's build this off. So these would need to be these. This needs to be these two. Oh boy. Make sure I pick up my batteries. Don't want to lose those boys. Mine hard for those resources. So get this up here. There we go. Now I have some room to work. Bah. Ah, there we go. And I probably could just do away with this unless I decide to do something else with it. Yeah, I built it out too long when I built this. It's okay though. Ah, there we go. So now I should be able to turn this back on and place the battery. Is it here? Then I should be able to do something like this. Ah, perfect. Just exactly what I wanted. That way I can hide this in the wall and not have to worry about it. All right. Well, I know this is not done, and I know it's just the basic concept of building, but that's all the time I have for today. If you like the idea of what I'm doing, please give the video a big thumbs up. And if you have any suggestions on what I should do other than what I'm actually doing, please leave a comment down below. But until next time, see you later.